Pongja Islet is about 56 kilometers northeast of Jilo. Along with nearby Mianhua Islet and Huaping Islet, they are known as the Three Northern Islets. The Three Northern Islets were formed from a volcanic eruption millions of years ago. Although not large in size, they enjoy rich resources of marine creatures from the seas around them. With its unique eco-environment and geolocation, it becomes a mysterious realm in the northeastern waters of Taiwan. Historical records in the Ming Dynasty indicate that Pongja Islet and Huaping Islet were already used to mark Chinese ambassadors' marine route to Liukyu. About 2 million years ago, the submarine volcano erupted. The volcanic lava flowed out and was later constantly deposited in layers. With additional tectonic movement and orographic uplift, Pongja Islet took its current form. Now, Pongja Islet is a coastal control zone of Taiwan, as well as the northernmost territorial sea base point. In addition to the Coast Guard, there is also a weather station here, set up by the Central Weather Bureau. It records weather changes on the seas of northern Taiwan. Looking over from the lighthouse at the highest point of the islet, we can vaguely see an area of slightly low-lying ground, which reminds us of the volcanic vent that gave birth to this islet. At the sea cliff in the northeast, we can find a basaltic lava flow, vented out in the last volcanic period. At the sea cliff in the east, complete eruptive layers can be seen on the Earth's surface. There is a rich variety of land-sea topography at the border between the two. The volcanic geology and sea-eroded landform are preserved completely, offering a unique landscape. On Mianhua Island, there are also valuable volcanic landforms. One conspicuous spectacle is a sea stack standing in the sea, Pingfong Rock. Huaping Islet, the smallest of the three, is mainly characterized by its volcanic rocks. The rocks are red because of their exposure to hot air and oxidation during the volcanic eruption. Due to their dangerous and difficult terrain, Mianhua and Huaping Islets stand alone in the sea. There are few human disturbances, and therefore they become the best habitat for seabirds. The Three Northern Islets also provide a temporary stay or habitat for many migratory birds, stragglers, and resident birds. So far, we have recorded many rare bird species, such as the brittle tern. And common noddy. Recently, researchers have found streaked shearwater chicks on the islets. This is the first record of streaked shearwaters breeding in Taiwan. Because of the volcanic landscape and particular habitat of rare bird species, the government of Geelong City declared Mianhua Islet, Huaping Islet, and the seas around them as a wildlife refuge. The three northern islets are located at the border between the warm Kuroshio Current and the cold China Coastal Current. When this current meets the marine water rich with nutrient salts, the two kinds of water mix together and well up to the shallow sea. With sufficiency in various food sources, different kinds of marine species gather abundantly in this sea region. Seriola demerali, also known as purplish amberjack, tends to swim in groups. Their primary food includes invertebrates and small fishes. Prionaris scalprum, known as scalpel sawtail, often swim in groups in the middle surface layer, nibbling the algae on the reef rocks. They're like a group of sea nomads. Moreover, with stocks of migratory fishes coming here, this sea area contains a huge amount of fish resources. The volcanic marine sediment at the seabed of the three northern islets is a matrix including many marine creatures. At the seabed 10 to 20 meters underwater, where the sunshine can reach, there are small groups of coral reefs. Coral seedlings are brought by the Kuroshio. Here the water is colder and more suitable for macroalgae. Therefore, benthic macroalgae are seen frequently on many reef rocks in this area. The white creatures that swing with the flow are not seaweed, although they look alike. These are clusters of sea cucumbers, stretching out many tentacles. Among them, the most prominent on the seabed are the Colochirus robustus, also known as yellow sea cucumbers. This probably means that the seawater in the northern sea area contains abundant organic substances, feeding the rarely seen sea cucumber clusters. In addition to the bountiful marine biological resources, there are also many rare species on land in the three northern islets, as confirmed in research reports. The coast mugwort, for example, is the most widely distributed plant on Mianhua Islet. Coast mugwort, also known as sea hibiscus, in Taiwan is only seen on the coastal slopes in the north and the rocky coasts in Lanyu and Green Island. The predominance of coast mugwort on Mianhua Islet, therefore, is a peculiar ecological landscape rarely seen in Taiwan. Lanyu beautyberry is another rare and endangered plant species that is listed as vulnerable. Its wild populations can still be found growing on Mianhua and Pengjia Islets. Besides this, on the beach sands of Pengjia Islet, we can see a plant species endemic to Taiwan, Justicia procumbens hirsutae. The ecology and environment of the Three Northern Islets is so unique that it cannot be found anywhere else in Taiwan. Nowadays, since Pengjia Islet is located on an important international navigation route, its lighthouse has been set up more than 100 years and become the most prominent landmark in this region. On Mianhua Islet, Wen Yingong Temple is built for worshipping the souls of the heroes who died at sea. Near the temple, the ruins of the previous settlements provide records of how people lived here in the past. The border between the ocean and the volcano. The robust vitality of species other than human beings has been ceaselessly performing the extraordinary drama of nature. Just like the convergent boundaries between the ocean and volcano, the seawater always brings forth a rich variety of life, enabling many species of precious life to proliferate and continue in this ancient ecological region.